Good morning, everyone. So today we are going to discuss about divisibility rules. So for that, first of all, I am going to give you some examples. So we'll first of all learn two examples. I hope all of you are able to know after drawing this, all of you are able to know that what is this. So this is a honeybee and this is a honeybee. So as you can see this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So this 5 makes a honeybee. Just like this is a 6. So if I remove one by one, just like this, then it will not make any honeybee. So I have to make such few steps so that it will make a honeybee. So likewise, in numbers, suppose I am writing a number 20. 24 is made up of 3 into 8, that is 3 into 2 into 2 into 2. So these numbers are nothing but called as factors of this number. So here we can say that these sets are the factors of the whole honeybee. So today we are going to learn divisibility rule. So first of all, see what is divisibility rule. And in that divisibility rule, we are going to use factors. That's why I have given you examples of factor. That what is the need of a factor? See, two numbers. Suppose a number, our first number is A, our second number is B. This is my first number, and this is my second number. These are the two numbers. So we can say that A is divisible by B if A is a factor of B. So our divisibility rule is nothing but, see, without doing the actual division, how can we find that which number is divisible by which number? See, suppose a number like this, 234, it is given to me. So using divisibility rule, we can easily find out that this number is divisible by which number, whether it is divisible by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or by another number. So here we are not going to do the actual division, but using this divisibility rule, we can simply find out that this number is divisible by which number. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the divisibility by 2. It is very simple. If a number whose ones place ends with, whose ones place is like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, or if you can say 0, but the number whose ones place is like this, that is 0, 2, 4, 6, and 8, then that number is divisible by 2. So, for example, 24. We can easily say that as its ones place is 4, we can say that 24 is divisible by 2. Another example, 382. Its ones place is 2, so we can say that 382 is divisible by 2. Just like this. So I think divisibility by 2 is now clear. So now we'll see divisibility by 3. It is also as simple as 2, but here the trick is the number which is given, if its sum of the digits will be divisible by 3, then it will be divisible by 3. Suppose 24 is given. So first of all, we have to add the digits. So that is 2 plus 4 and it is 6. And 6 is always divisible by 3. So we can say that this number 24 is divisible by 3. Here we have to check that whether the sum of the digits are divisible by 3 or not. So I think this is also clear. So now we have one more divisibility test, that is divisibility by 5. It is as simple as that. Here we only need to notice that the whether its ones place is ending with 0 or 5. If the ones place of a number is like is 0 and 5, then we can say that that number is divisible by 5. So for example, 50. So we can clearly say that this number is divisible by 5. 65. We can say that this, as its ones place is 5, we can say that it is divisible by 5. But 33, we can't say that it is divisible by 5 because it ones place is neither 0 nor 5. So now we have understood that divisibility by 2, 3, 5. Now for 6 also, it is same. For 6 also, we have to add the digits. Suppose we want to know whether 24 is divisible by 6 or not. Its addition is 6, so we can clearly say that 24 is divisible by 6. Suppose let's see for another number, 242. So we'll add 2 plus 4 plus 2, that is 2 plus 4, 6 plus 2, 8. But see, 8 is not divisible by 6. So we can't say that this number is divisible by 6. See, you can check like this also. Just a second. See, I can check 242, 5, 6. 6 4 is 24, 0 or 2. We didn't get the remainder 0. So we can see if we do the simple division, it will take time. But just by seeing that sum of the digits, it is 2 plus 4, 6 plus 2, 8. So, and we know that 8 is not divisible by 6. So we can clearly say that 242 is not divisible by 6. I hope this is clear now. So now we'll see the divisibility test for 9. Here also we need to see what is the last digit of the number. Suppose we are having number, and here see if the last number are like this 3, 9 and all, then it is divisible by 9. And also we need to check, suppose we are having 80. We have a number 80. So we need to first add these two numbers, that is 1 plus 8, that is 9. And 9 is obviously divisible by 9. So we can say that 18 is divisible by 9. Likewise, you can check for other numbers as well. Suppose we are having 591. We need to check the divisibility of by 9. So we'll add 5 plus 9. Plus 1. So 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 15. But 15 is not divisible by 9. So 591 is not divisible by 9. Now the last one is divisibility by 10. It is as simple as. For 10, we only need to see the last digit, ones place number. If it ends with 0, then we'll say that the number is divisible by 10. For example, 50, 100, 60, 10, 1000. All these numbers are divisible by 10. If its last digit is 0. I hope this will give you a clear idea about divisibility rules. So these are the rules that by which we can say that the number is divisible by which number. I hope all of you have understood well. Thank you so much and have a great day.